session, let us learn about this keyword. Already we have used this. This refers the current object. In this particular example, we have used the this keyword to initialize the instance variables. This dot name equal to name, wherein this refers to the current object. Now we are going to learn about this of, like a method. Where exactly this of can be used? It can be used only inside the constructor. This of is used to move across constructors in the same class. Now let me go in for an example. I have got demo.java. I have got three constructors. Default, one with int as parameter, one with string as parameter. I am trying to create an object and call it. What will be the output? I will just get hello. What if I want to get all the three output? In that case, I need to create three objects of demo class. Instead of that, I can go in for this keyword to move across the constructors in the same class. How to do that? Let me explain. The output what I want is welcome Ram, value 10 and hello. So when you create an object, it will go to the first constructor, a default constructor. In the first line, you have not written anything. Meaning to say that you have not used the super keyword. You know what is the purpose of super? Super is used to go to the super class constructor. The control will be taken to the super class constructor. Now what I am going to do is, I am going to use this keyword, this of. The parameters within this should match at least one constructor in the same class. Now I want to go into the constructor having int as parameter. So let me pass on a value 10. Now what will happen? It will go from this particular line number 6, it will enter into line number 10. It will enter into this particular constructor. Now, can I write super next to this? No. Either this or super can be in the first line of any constructor. Because I have used this, the control is moved from the default constructor to the constructor which is having int as parameter. It will not go to the object class. Now, from this, from line number 10, I want to go to line number 15. That is, I want to call the constructor which is having string as parameter. What I have to do? Again, I have to use this of match the constructor by passing a string. Now, I am passing Ram. Okay. Now, what will happen? From this place, the controller will be moved to this constructor. The constructor which is taking string as argument. Now, can I again use this keyword? There are only three constructors. If I am using this of, what will happen? It's like a stack overflow. You are calling the method again and again. Right? It will give you a compiler error. I cannot use this. Now what will happen? If you don't write anything inside the constructor in the first line, or if there is no super keyword in the first line, the compiler itself will introduce a super keyword here. You know where it will go? It will go to the constructor of the super class. What is the super class of demo? Object class. It will go to the object class constructor, initialize if there are any instance variables to the default value, and it will come back to the same place. Remember always, whenever the control is going to some other method, it will go back, it will go do the work and come back to the same place from where it was called. So similarly, when you call super, it goes to the object class constructor and comes back. And then what it will print? It will print welcome Ram. Then again it will go back to line number 11, it will print value 10. So what is the flow? 1, then 2, then this is 3, then this is 4, this is 5. Again after completing welcome yes, it will go back here, right? So this is 6, then it is printing value 10. From there it will go to the default constructor, print hello, finally come back to public static void main. So the purpose of this of is to move across the constructors in the same class. This keyword can be used only in the first line. This dot you can use in any line in the constructor, but this of can be used only in the first line of any constructor. The parameters within this should match any of the constructors which are available in that particular class. Now let us try this out. Now what I want from here, where it will go? It will go to line number 6. In this line, I am going to give this of 10. What will happen if I give super in the next line? It will give me a compiler error. You cannot have this and super at the same time. It means like you are trying to send the control to the constructor in the same class and also to a constructor in the object class, which is not possible. So, I have used this keyword alone. Next, from here it will come to this line number 10. Here I am using this of RAM. From here, now if I try to use this keyword again, it will give me a compiler error. Okay, it becomes circular. Now let me remove this. I am not giving anything in the first line. So the compiler itself will introduce a super keyword. It will go to the object class and it will come back. And then it will print welcome RAM, value 10 and hello. Now let me save this. Control F11. Welcome RAM, value 10 and hello. Okay, this is fine, well and good, it is working. Now, what if I want the output in the other way around? I want to print hello, welcome RAM, value 10. Which output you want first should be called last. So, if I want my output as hello, value 10 and welcome RAM, what I have to do is, I will again go back to this pictorial representation here. Now, I want the output as hello, welcome RAM, value 10. So, what object will you create? Which output you want last should be called first. So, I need to pass 10 over here. From this line number 19, it will come to line number 10. Then, what is the second output you want? Welcome RAM. So, from line number 10, it has to come to line number 15. In this case, you have to pass this. From this line, it will go here. Remove this and you have to give super. Or you can leave it free. Okay? Now, we will modify the code and we will check it out. So, here let me modify the code. I am passing 10. So, from this place where it will come? It will come to line number 10. Again, I am passing RAM only. Because what output I want? Hello, welcome RAM, value 10. It is, from this line number 10, it has to go to line number 15. In this case, I am passing this. I will remove this. I am saving it. Let me execute. Hello, welcome RAM, value 10. Now, what if I don't have this keyword here? Now, what will be the output? It will go to the constructor in line number 8. It will, again from there, it will go to the constructor in line number 13. Then, it will, you have not used this keyword. So, where it will go? It will go to the super class constructor, come back, it will print welcome RAM, then go back to line number 10 and it will print value 10. Now, control F11, see the output, welcome RAM and value 10. What we are doing? We are totally masking this constructor. Because we have not used this keyword, this constructor is getting masked. This is all fine. But what is the real purpose of this keyword? In the student class, whatever we have done in the previous program, you can see that we are rewriting the code again and again, trying to initialize name and student ID in all the constructors. Suppose I am having 5 constructors. In all the 5 constructors, I am trying to initialize name and ID. It means that you are doing the work again and again. How this can be minimized? This can be minimized with the help of this keyword, this of. So, for this, let us see an example. Let me create a mobile class with 3 instance variables. This is my mobile class. Now, let me add 4 constructors. One is the default constructor, then one with 1 parameter, one with 2 parameter and one with 3 parameters. So, how to do that? Keep the cursor inside the class. Go to source, generate constructors from superclass. This is for the default constructor. What is the superclass? Object. Click OK. So the constructor is created. Now let me remove the lines which are here and give a simple println statement in default. Now let me create a constructor with model alone, with model and price, with brand model and price. So go to source, generate constructor using field, select model alone, click OK. Then go to source, generate constructor using fields, select model and price, click OK. Then finally, with all the 3, click OK. So, all the 4 constructors are created. You see here, model is being initialized in all the constructors again and again. And the super keyword is also coming by default because Eclipse is supporting it. Now, to know the flow, let me add println statements in all the constructors. You cannot add println statement before the super keyword because super has to be in the first line. Okay, let me add one more method also. So I have added the get details method just to print brand, model and price. Okay, the next step is I need to create a class which is going to have public static void main. Let us run the application once and then I will show you what is the real purpose of this keyword. Now I have created a class, this demo with public static void main. I have created four objects and trying to call get details method. This will work fine. Let me save it. Let me execute. You can see you are getting whatever you have given inside the constructor. In default, one parameter, two parameter and three parameter. And it is trying to print all the output, whatever you have given, mobile details output. Right? Everything is working fine and we are getting the output. In which scenario will we going for this keyword? Let me explain that. To make it clear, I am just going to comment the first three objects and the corresponding calling part. So what I am having? I am having an object with three parameters. So let me select this mobile, press F3. It will take me into the corresponding constructor. So I am coming to a constructor which is having three parameters. From here, where it is going? Automatically it is going to the object class constructor. What I want is, I want to stop this and I am going to send the flow to the other constructor which is also going to do the initialization of model and price. So what I can do, I can remove these two lines and I will ask the other constructor to initialize the values for me. So I am going to pass model, comma price. Okay, so now what will happen? When you are entering into this constructor with the value, what is the value we have got? C456 and Samsung and the price. It will come here. C456 and the price will be taken to the constructor in line number 14. If you see in line number 14, you are initializing model and price. But there is one more constructor which is really doing the work of initializing the model alone. So what I will do, I will remove the super keyword from here and then I will ask that constructor to initialize the model for me. So I will use this of model. Okay. So I don't need this key, this line now. Okay. Now I have modified it and now coming to this first constructor in line number 9, you are initializing the model and do we need to go to the mobile class, I mean the default constructor? We don't need it, so directly we can go to the object class constructor. So what will be the flow? Once when the JVM is entering into this method, it will enter into this constructor. It will go to the constructor which is having three parameters with the value. C456, Samsung and the price, say 678, whatever I have given. Now, what I am doing is, I am asking the other constructor to initialize the model and price for me. Only the brand will be initialized by this particular constructor. So what will happen? From line number 20, it will go to line number 15. In line number 15, we are understanding that there is one more constructor which is going to initialize the model. So the flow is, it will go from line number 15 to line number 10. From line number 10, it will go to the object class, come back, initialize model and then give it. It's like there are three people, A, B, C. A has to do all the work. Instead of that, he is sending it to B, B is sending it to C, C is doing part of the work or quarter of the work and giving it back to B. B is taking the value and attaching its own work and sending it to A. Now, A has got model and price initialized. So, what is the last work to be done? A has to initialize the brand. So, A is initializing it. So, I hope this part is clear. What we are doing is, rather than rewriting the code again and again, using this of, we are trying to initialize the instance variables using different constructors in the same class. Now, let me execute this. Let me save it. Coming back to this demo, control F11. See, what is the flow? It goes actually to the constructor with three parameters. From there going to the constructor with two parameters. From there going to the constructor with one parameter. Initialize model, come back, initialize price, come back, initialize brand and go to public static void main again. Then when you call get details method, it is printing all the output properly. Okay, what if I want to print in default also? I want to print this also. So what should I do? I have to remove the super and now I can give this keyword. So what will happen? From line number 20, it will go to line number 14. From line number 15, it will go to line number 9. From line number 10, it will go to line number 6. Now here you have not used this or super keyword. So the compiler will introduce a super keyword. It will go to the super class, come back and it will print this in default. Then come here, initialize the model and it will print in one parameter. Come here, initialize the price and it will print in two parameter. Initialize brand and it will print in three parameter. Now let me save this and run the application. You can see the output over here. So this is the original purpose of using this soft keyword. It is used to call the constructors in the same class for initializing the instance variables in a different way. So rather than you rewriting the code again and again in all the constructors to initialize the instance variables, you can go in for this kind of, you can go in for using this keyword. I will also show you one more thing. I have got a constructor with two parameters, right? Now here. Okay, I am trying to call the constructor with two parameters. I am just giving a break over here by using system.out.println. Let me execute this. I am maximizing the console. You can see this is for the first constructor and this is for the second constructor. For the first constructor, it is going to in default in one parameter, in two parameter. For the second constructor, in default 1, 2 and 3 parameter. Okay, and you are getting the proper output as such. Let me add a println statement here also. Now, let me execute this. So, what will be the flow? From mock 3, it will go to the constructor with 2 parameters. Go and call the constructor with 1 parameter. Call the constructor with no parameters. So, the output will be in default, in 1 parameter, in 2 parameter. Then again, go back. For the constructor with 3 parameters, it will print in default 1, 2 and 3 parameter and then it will print the output. Now let us check the output. You can see the output over here. This part is for the constructor with 2 parameters. This part is for the constructor with 3 parameters. So this is the use of this soft keyword. It is used to move across constructors in the same class. That's it. Thank you.